It's time to give back as we team with local musicians to show the variety of service options available at Community Action in Provo. Tell us about this amazing place.
Well, Community Action, what we do is we try to get people out of poverty. So we do everything from helping them get food to actually giving them the resources that they can leave poverty. Poverty, it's a hard situation to be in. It's living in crisis. And so we don't want to just glaze over the problem and give a band-aid solution. What we really want to do is solve it so that these people can live a happy life. So what we do is a two-step process. The first is to end that crisis, you know, stabilize their life. And we do that with things like the food and the food bank. But then we also give out gas vouchers for people that maybe have an interview somewhere and they need to get there, or even housing assistance for people that are going to lose their house or maybe are homeless at the moment. So we end that crisis. And then we have the second step of rebuilding their life. And through the rebuilding process, we have the Circles Initiative, which pairs them up with someone from the middle or wealthy class and helps them to learn skills that they normally wouldn't have access to. But we also have housing counselors. So if you're upside down on your mortgage or you want to buy a house for the first time, you can actually do it and not be scared that you're going to get in a bad loan, or if you are in a bad loan, you can get out of it. Circles Initiative is really cool. To me, it's the future of fighting poverty. And the reason why is because it takes the person that's in poverty and pairs them up with three people from the middle class. And it's just making intentional friendships. And the phrase I like to use with that is that when people come together, good things happen. So it just opens doors that normally these people wouldn't have access to, like how to open a bank account or how to get a driver's license. Sometimes these people never had anyone in their life that knew how to do that.
We've got holidays coming up, and the need never goes away. How could people get involved with Community Action?
Well, you've got a good point. The need rises certainly during the holidays with the extra stress of Christmas and Thanksgiving, but the need never goes away. It's all year round. So if you want to get involved and volunteer, we always need people in the food bank. You know, you can help unload a truck or help sort the food, but we also need people in the Circles program and people to do food drives with their neighbors.
A dollar can provide how much food for a family?
7 pounds.
7 pounds for $1. That's incredible.
So it's mostly the little overhead that we have, the money goes to help pay for that. So there are some paid staff, but mostly you're paying for the gas in the trucks to get the food to the people, the electric for the freezer to keep the cold food cold so it doesn't go bad. And that's how we can stretch that money so much. When somebody donates their food or their time or even their money to Community Action, what they're really doing is helping give people hope. Because the first thing to go when you're living in poverty is your faith in the future. And so once you have the food that you're not living paycheck to paycheck, and once you have an idea of how you can actually get out of poverty, it really makes a difference in somebody's life. It's really giving hope to those that are hopeless.
Where can people go to find out more about Community Action?
So they can visit our website at communityactionuc.org.
Fantastic. Well, thank you for your time.
You bet.
God bless you, brother.